Since a few weeks, we use Firecut to edit our videos. You might have heard about this tool already if you watch Ali Abdaal's videos. This is not a sponsored video, it's just a video where we want to show you Firecut, how we use it, and why we like it. So Firecut is an AI video editor. It is an extension for Premiere Pro. So you need Premiere Pro and you need Firecut, which is also a paid tool. Check the pricing here to get started. Once installed, you can find Firecut in the extensions in Premiere Pro. And one thing we really like about Firecut is its simplicity. These are all the core options Firecut ships with. So we have options to remove unwanted sections of our audio tracks. We can add information to our video track by adding zooms and by editing multi-track videos with the help of AI. And we can add chapters and captions to enhance the content of our video. Now, obviously, we don't use all of these features to edit our videos, so I want to show you the core features we use. This is an episode of our podcast. It's shortened to 8 minutes to speed this up a bit here. And once we have all our tracks in the sequence, we start by removing the silences from the sequence. You have a basic and advanced setting. We use advanced because this will give us a list of all the silences that will be cut out, so we have more control about the editing process. In here, we keep everything with the default setting and start analyzing our audio. Once the analysis is done, you can define things like the threshold. So if you have more quiet parts in your video that should not be identified as silence, you can adjust this here. You can also adjust the minimum silence duration. You have plenty of options to customize the cutout process. We typically stick to the default settings though for our first editing process. And down here is the grade part. There I get a list of all the silences found that will be cut out. So I can select the first one and then I can check. Well, if that's all right, in this case it is, I can jump to the next one. Same thing. Is a grade also good and so on. So I can check all the different silences. And if I decide that one of these silences should be kept, I can just delete it from the list. Now I'm done and with go, the identified silences will be cut out. I can always undo any step in Firecut with this undo option. I can confirm that it should be undone again. And with that, I'm back at the initial state of my sequence. Here, we'll delete the silences though to finish this process. Removing filler words like am and is also very helpful. Again, there are not too many settings that we change. We only change the scope to full sequence for our purposes here and then start the analysis. I now get a list of all filler words that were identified. I can jump to these in my sequence. If these should remain in my video, I can just right click and unselect these. By right clicking again, I reselect the words. By the way, I can also unselect other words, which we won't do here. With cut selected words, the sequence will now be edited according to the list that we just saw. Remove repetition is the third removal option. The general settings are again the same ones that we saw before. However, this is not something we use because this part of the video editing is something we do on our own because we want to have full control about the words spoken in our videos. It works quite well, actually. We tried it. Still, we prefer not using this removing feature. Therefore, I'll not dive into this. Adding zooms is also something we don't use. So we add any zooms on our own. It also works quite well. You have lots of settings to adjust. The AI also analyzes the words to make sure the zoom fits into the actual context of what you're saying. Still, something we don't do for our projects. What we heavily use though is the multi-track feature. The multi-track feature is important if you have more than one video track. Because here we have two cameras. We have one camera focusing myself, and we have the other camera focusing Max. And of course, to keep the podcast dynamic, we want to switch the perspectives frequently. Before we knew Firecut, we did this manually, which wasn't too satisfying. With Firecut, this is pretty easy now, because all you have to do is, you have to identify the speakers for the corresponding audio track. So in this case, audio one is Max, and audio two is myself. And now we have to allocate the corresponding video tracks to these audio tracks. So in this case, video one is again Max because this here is Mac's video track, and therefore the second video is my track. Now we start the analysis again. And again, this brings us an option menu where we can change things like the switching frequency for the speakers. You can also define the max shot duration, which we typically reduce to around about 30 seconds. And then the only important option we use is this cutting operation option. Here we only disable the inactive video clips. We don't delete these because this gives us again more control about our content. Down here you can now see what the cuts will look like. So when the video track will switch to which person. And with Go, Firecut now starts this editing process, starting with the first video track and continuing with the second one. And if you're not happy with any of these tracks, you can always add a cut here and there and enable another track and disable the other one. So with that, you can always edit the final result that Firecut created. The final feature we use in Firecut is adding captions. And we use this feature to generate the captions for the podcast in general. So we go to add captions, full sequence, and transcribe this sequence. And in the text only menu, we can now export the captions as SRT or VTT. We also get a preview of the captions, but we also have this styled section here, and that's the more interesting one. This is used to add these short like captions to our videos. To do that though, we typically copy an existing sequence, change the resolution of our sequence, adjust the video track to focus each of the speakers, create a short. So that's not a real short, it's just a short video here for demonstration purposes. Reload the plugin, go to add captions, full sequence, and transcribe these. Now we can check whether our transcript was created correctly in this menu. So you can edit the captions directly in here. And if that's correct, we either use one of the presets that Firecut ships with, which we can customize down here with many different options, and which we can then save as our new preset, like we did it with our Acad preset right here. And once this is done, we add these style captions to our sequence. And now we easily created a short with these nice burnt-in captions with Firecut in seconds. This is how we use Firecut, so we hope this video is helpful to you if you're just getting started with the tool. Of course, if you have any tips and tricks how to improve our workflow, how to use Firecut more efficiently, feel free to comment, because as always, your feedback is very welcome.